Dear friend, today we will discuss the, it will be very important now with the caudatympanine nerve, not only the caudatympanine nerve. Caudatympanine nerve, as you know, carry the 10 sensation from the anterior to third tongue and also carry the or transfer the secretomotor fibers for the submandibular and the sublingual salivary gland. Here, now this caudatympanine nerve is a branch of the facial nerve. Look here, the facial nerve is here, is in the pons medulla. Okay, here. In the pons and the medulla, this is the superior salivary nucleus, one here, and the nucleus of the recta solitarius, which extends into the medulla here. Now, the facial nerve after arising from the pons, suppose this is the facial nerve, after arising from the pons here at the gligus level, after arising pons, it enters into the internal acoustic meatus here. Okay, as you know, it enters into through the internal acoustic meatus. Ascends a course, okay, but it ascends upward like this and turns and then enters into the facial canal like this. Okay, so this is known as the genu, okay, genu of the facial nerve, external genu. Now, here, and this is the internal acoustic meatus there. So the secret, so this is the here the superior salivary nucleus here. This superior salivary nucleus gives rise to the secretomotor fiber. Which passes through the facial nerve. Okay. Here. Passes through the facial nerve. And here when the facial nerve comes out through the stato mastoid foramen here. It comes out of the sternomastoid foramen here. Now 6 mm above from the exit of the facial nerve from the sternomastoid foramen, this secretomotor fiber from the facial nerve separated here in the form of the caudatympanine nerve here. And this caudatympanine, this fiber, the caudatympanine nerve comes out from the middle ear cavity through a posterior to the tympanic membrane. Suppose this is the tympanic membrane. Okay, here. And so a foramen. Okay. So a foramen, this is a posterior canaliculus. Okay, here. This is not the posterior canaliculus. So this foramen here. Yeah. It comes out, the caudatympanine nerve passes from the, comes out to the posterior canaliculus and it passes through the junction of the pars tensa and pars flaccida of the tympanic membrane here. Okay, so this is the pars flaccida and the pars tensa here. And this nerve passes between the mucous membrane and the fibrous part of the tympanic membrane just medial to the handle of the malleus here. Suppose. This is the handle of the malleus. This is the malleus one and the handle of the malleus. So this passes medial to the handle of the malleus covered by the mucous membrane of the tympanic mucous layer of the tympanic membrane here. And then this passes, comes up, passes the anterior border of the tympanic membrane and it enters for the anterior canaliculus here. So this is the anterior canaliculus. Okay, now through the anterior canaliculus, it comes out here through the medial end of the petrotympanic fissure from the, in the base of the skull here. So this is the petrotympanic fissure here. It passes this between the anterior canaliculus and the petrotympanic fissure, it passes through a small canal here. This is a small canal. Yeah. and then it comes out the middle part of the petrotympanic fissure. Okay, yeah, it comes out the medial part of the petrotympanic fissure and then passes medial to the spine of the sphenoid bone here. This is the spine of the sphenoid bone here. Okay, yeah. This is the petrotympanic fissure here, just behind the here. Foramen ovale. Okay, yeah. So, and this is the spine of the sphenoid bone. So, it passes medial to the spine of the sphenoid bone or crosses the spine of the sphenoid bone here and then descends downward in the infratemporal fossa. Okay, here. Yeah. Infratemporal fossa here. Yeah. And then it unites with the lingual nerve, with the acute angle, and then fiber passes through the, so these are the fiber of the caudal tympani nerve which runs through the lingual nerve. Clear? So here, if we see the relation of the caudal tympani nerve in the infratemporal region, in the infratemporal region, it is laterally related to the lateral, this middle surface of the lateral pterygoid muscle first. Okay. Second, it is related to the spine of the sphenoid because it passes medial to the spine of the sphenoid. Also, it is related to the middle meningeal artery. Middle meningeal artery passes through the foramen spinosum here. So, it is related laterally from this middle meningeal artery along with the auriculotemporal nerve. Auriculotemporal nerve also related to the lateral to this caudal tympani nerve. Along with the inferior alveolar nerve. Inferior alveolar nerve comes here, so the posterior division of the medullar nerve. So when it descends downward, it is related to the caudal tympani nerve laterally here. Okay. So these are the certain structure related later to the caudal tympani nerve. Medially it is related to the tensor palatine muscle here. Tensor palatine muscle starts from the here, the auditory tube here, and then descend downward. So tensor palatine muscle related to the medial to this caudal tympani nerve. Okay. And the posteriorly here, or this, there is a mandibular nerve trunk, aortic ganglia is there. Okay. So posterior to the aortic ganglia here, this nerve related here. So and anterior to the caudal tympani nerve we can say there is the aortic ganglia. Okay, so these are the structure related to the caudal tympani nerve. Yeah. Now this caudal tympani nerve, much as we can already have seen, enters into the lingual nerve and passes the secretory motor fiber passes from the lingual nerve. Now what about the, what's happening the lingual nerve here? Suppose this is the lingual nerve. Okay, here, and these are the fiber of the caudal tympani nerve. Okay, now fiber of the caudal tympani nerve passes. It is come, the preganglionic fiber come here and this is the submandibular ganglia. Okay. Okay, so the preganglionic fiber which runs from the lingual nerve comes out and into the submandibular ganglia, thus above the deep part of the submandibular gland here, and postganglionic fibers start here and then enters into the submandibular gland here. Okay. Now, remaining of the postganglionic fiber again enters into the lingual nerve and then runs from the lingual nerve and then here anterior to this deep part is a sublingual gland. Okay. Yeah. And it is very close to the lingual nerve. Okay. So again this fiber, the postganglionic fiber separate here and enters into the sublingual gland here. So through this lingual nerve, the caudal tympani nerve, secretory motor fiber supply the submandibular gland and the sublingual gland. What about the taste sensation fiber? Now taste sensation fiber from the anterior two third of the tongue here, okay, passes through the lingual nerve, okay, then it separates and enters into the caudal tympani nerve, which comes the secretory motor fiber coming here, and enters into the caudal tympani nerve, passes through the caudal tympani nerve, okay, here, passes, and the primary, these are the primary neuron. Okay, now the this is the geniculate ganglia. Okay, here geniculate ganglia of the facial nerve. The cell body of the geniculate ganglia is situated in the fiber of the cell body of the taste sensation fiber. Present here the geniculate ganglia, and from the geniculate ganglia fiber passes here and enters into the pons in the medulla, and these are the taste sensation fiber here, the nucleus of the tractus solitarius. So for the in the tractus solitarius here, the secret of this taste sensation fiber passes through the caudal tympani now and then enters into the here the tractus solitarius. So here the body is situated here in the geniculate ganglia. So these are the secretomotor fiber and the taste sensation fiber here. Now it is very important to understand now here in this region here. In this region, this caudal tympani nerve is also communicated with the otic ganglia here. Suppose this is the otic ganglia, and then this caudal tympani nerve sends the taste sensation fiber here for the otic ganglia, and from the otic ganglia nerve fiber passes through the lesser petrosana and glossopharyngeal nerve, enters into the superior salivary nucleus here. So this is an alternate pathway. We can say this is an alternate pathway. When the caudal tympani nerve is damaged somewhere here. So what's happened now? The taste sensation fiber passes from the caudal tympani nerve through the otic ganglia and enters into lesser petrosana nerve, then enters into the brainstem nucleus of the tractus solitarius. So these are the alternative pathway of the taste sensation of the anterior tooth of the tongue. So this is, I think, all about the caudal tympani now. And this caudal tympani is very important here. Two things is important here. One is that it passes medial to the spine of the sphenoid. So whenever there is a fracture of the spine of the sphenoid occur here, this fracture leads to the damage, to the injury to the caudal tympani now. Second thing is here, this nerve is joined with the lingual nerve, the acute angle here. So somewhere the damage occur here in the lingual nerve, it can damage the caudal tympani now. And third thing, more important thing is here, this caudal tympani now runs just medial to the handle of the malleus, covered by the mucous membrane of the tympanic membrane here. On the medial side, it passes between the mucous membrane and the fibrous layer of the tympanic membrane. So whenever there is any perforation occur, any operation done in this here, so always the ENT surgeon take care, do not damage this caudal tympani now in this region. So I think this is all about the caudal tympani. Thank you.